Dear Chairman, thank you for the invitation to present at the EBC 2020 meeting. The title of my presentation is Bifurcation PCA, Provisional Standing of LAD D1 in ACS. This is a 65-year-old male presented with a recent onset of chest pain associated with shortness of breath, diagnosed as a case of unstable angina. ECG, nothing significant, 2D echo, no RWM, good LV function, HB at 12.5 grams, blood urea 14 milligrams, and serum creatinine 0.83, GFR 92 ml, and RBS 86, drop eye positive. Angiogram showed a long segment lesion involving proximal to middle AD. There is a significant bifurcation lesion involving the D1 LAD junction, right femoral root, 7 French EBU, 3.5 guiding catheter. The LAD was crossed with turn track Y and BMW Y was placed in D1. Whether to go ahead with a single stent technique or two stent technique, 7 randomized studies with the deaths compared 1 versus 2 stents approach and 8 meta-analysis have showed no advantage in using systematic two stent technique. Stepwise provisional, this is the gold standard for most bifurcation lesions. The primary outcome in all bifurcations, that is a simple strategy, showed 16.6% versus 22% in complex strategy. In non-LM bifurcations, that simple strategy showed 14.8% versus 16.4% in complex strategy. Again, in LM bifurcation lesions also, it's a complex bifurcation lesion showed significantly increased target vessel failure. The stepwise approach to provisional stent technique, first wire both vessels, pre-dilate the main but not the side, stent according to the distal reference diameter, perform the pot with adequately sized balloon, and optional kiss if there is a suboptimal result. Even after pot or even after kiss, if the suboptimal result is there, there is the option for second stent, that is T-tap or T-R coulette. Before you do the provisional stenting, assess the side branch. The side branch, is it functionally significant? Do the FFR and no angioclinical correlation is there. You can perform the imaging and assess the plug button, assess the mean luminal area, that is in left main, a bifurcation if the L6 is less than 3.7 square mm, a plug button is more than 56%. And definitely these patients require side branch intervention. If then compromise of the side branch is not at risk, that is provisional stenting is the best method, that the side branch protection at the operator discretion. If side branch is intervention is required, if there is an ischemia or if there is any symptomatic, the side branch is at risk of compromise, not suitable for two stent technique, you can go ahead with the keep it open strategy, or you can use the jailed balloon technique or jailed microcatheter technique. At risk of compromise, suitable for two stent technique, either provisional versus two stent technique, and considered elective two stent strategy, side branch wiring is anticipated to be very difficult. You assess the block. Is it fibrous or lipid or fibrocalcific? If there is severe calcification is there, block modification is required using the rota or IVL. Or orbital atherectomy. Very tightly stenosed, microcalcifications are there, even macrophages are there. A plenty of fibrolipid block. Side branch is very well patterned. The left main is very huge. You can see the left main 23 square mm and diameter 5.4 and proximal landing zone area, mean luminal area, 9.32 square mm and the diameter is 3.5. We have taken OCT from here, but still there is a block. We thought it is not that significant block, but OCT showed significant block. MLA is 2.5 square mm and the diameter is 1.8. So our intention, because this is having a significant block burden, better to extend up to this level. So then we took the, there are predictors of side branch closure. That is bifurcation point to carina tip length. If that is less than 1.75 mm, closure is more likely. That carina tipple angle, if less than 51 degree, again, closure is more likely. And spiky carina, here there is no spiky carina, angle is more than 70 degree. And bifurcation point to carina tip length is 3 mm. So closure very unlikely. So once you do the stenting, any side branch compromise, that also you can do the FFR or you can do the imaging and see side branch is compromised or not. Selection of this stent should be based upon the main branch diameter, distal diameter. Otherwise, the carina can shift. If you are choosing the stent based upon the main vessel, it can shift the carina and it can cause the compromise of the side branch. And when you do the part, don't extend beyond the carina tip angle, just proximal to the carina tip, keep the entire LED wherever a tight lesion was there, it was dilated adequately. Post scoring OCT image showed the diameter we have chosen based upon the angiography guidance, because we have taken place. See, we are landing in the block, it has to be covered because this is a lipid rich block. If you leave, if you don't stent this one, it may lead to future edgery stenosis. Once implantation was done, immediately you have to do the part. If you don't do part, there is a gap. If you want to place the side branch wire, again, it can go subliminally between the stent and vessel wall. If you are pushing the balloon, it can go subliminally and it can cause the longitudinal stent deformation. So entire LED was optimized using 3.5 to 12 mm NC dot distal optimization technique. Distal LED stenting covered with 3 into 12 mm stent. We recrossed BMW wire. So this is mainly to see, because we are using the OCT, any struts are across the side branch ostium to see whether how is the apposition expansion. Distally, there is no edge dissection. Proximally, there is no edge dissection. It is expanded very well, expansion is more than 100%. And distal, if you see 6.42 square mm, distal reference zone is MLA is 5.43. So more than 100% expansion achieved, opposed very well here. But proximally, there is a significant malapposition. It is an under-expanded stent. If you see, the size of the vessel diameter is 4.2 square mm. So better to take a bigger balloon and apposite. Analyze the side branch ostia. Stent struts across the side branch ostium. He crossed it proximally. Always cross distal strut to get the best optimization results. Otherwise, it can lead to malapposition. Suppose if you are using OCT, you can cross proximally, distally, based upon whether is it link-free carina or not. Significant malapposition proximally. Here, 39%. Here, the vessel size is 4.2. Then we took the 4.5 mm balloon. Then we expanded it further. We did the kissing balloon to separate that struts across the side branch. When you do the kissing, it can lead to bottleneck deformity. It can cause stress on the block as well as the vessel wall. Always you correct with the part. Another option, alternate to final kissing balloon, perform the LED is flowing very well. Side branch is very well patterned. You can see the proximal portion of the stent. Very clearly, a diagonal is very well patterned. Expansion is 93%. And this is the distal portion of the stent. Expansion is 88%. And the stent is nicely expanded. You can see nicely flowing LED with a good antegrade flow. So image-guided bifurcation PCA, useful in determining the strategy, whether you want to go ahead with a single stent strategy or two stent strategy based upon the side branch assessment. And you can assess the block, whether it's a calcified or lipid or fibrous block, based upon that appropriate the block modification strategy you can decide. And the sizing of the balloon and stent can be decided based upon the OCT imaging. And post-PCA optimization helps in identifying and rectifying predictors of the death outcome. Mainly, medial dissection is there or not. And either side, like a proximal edge or distal edge, medial dissection is there, you rectify it. Is it opposed very well or not? Is it expanded well or not? These are the important features.